my pretties, we fly! Hi, my lovely witchy bumblebees, it's Ethany. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be talking about the magic of besomes or witches' brooms. And while I talk a little bit about the magic and use of the broom, I am going to be making or decorating this one that I found at a Canadian Tire. If you're in, I don't know, Australia, go to your Bunnings. Gosh, do I ever miss a good old snag, a sausage sizzle from Bunnings. Say hi to your local Bunnings for me, everyone in Australia. And in America, I don't know, go wherever you, Home Depot, I guess, they're here as well. Go grab one. This was like literally $8. It's a corn broom and you can decorate it to make your very own besom. I also have this little mini besom that I got in a witch's moon box a little while ago, and it is a perfect addition to my altar. So I bought this little one here to show you that you don't need to do a massive broom or besom for your practice. So why have witches and brooms been so connected, and why is it such a stereotypical image of a witch riding a broom? There are fantastic ones such as Samantha from Bewitched, also from one of my favorite movies, Come We Fly, from Hocus Pocus.
Come We Fly!
Now this is not a history lesson, but if you actually take a look at witches and brooms or besomes, you will find that in the 1600s, there was a connection between brooms and flying ointments, which are hallucinogenics that were said that the witches used to fly off to the Sabbat, and was often put on the broom, and then the witch would nakedly straddle the broom and absorb it through the skin and ride off to the Sabbat. Now, basically, she's getting her kicks and going off to a party naked. I don't see what the problem is. What's the problem? Oh, right. Yes, men hate women having pleasure. Got it. I remember that now. And then they were heavily persecuted for that. You can have a look at some of the art and literature of the times to see how witches were portrayed in the Sabbath. But now I'm going to make a real witch's broom. And you know what? If you want to put hallucinogens on there and do whatever, I guess it's your life. So before I jump in, I'm just going to show you some of the things I'm quickly going to put on this broom to make it a little bit more decorative, festive, beautiful. I have got some flowers and some loose flowers with little trim. They're fake so that it will last all year long, from Michaels. And then I've got some flower cord and wire, so I'm going to wire them on, and a whole bunch of my beading tools so that I can put them on this besom. You can watch me drive the struggle bus through Struggle Town as I try to do this. It's been a hot minute. Why do witches use brooms? Now, witches use brooms to help them sweep the space. Brooms would never touch the floor, and they would be used to cleanse your area before you cast the circle. Would have been helpful to do this before. Another really fantastic practice that has actually kind of, it's still around, it's still being its thing, is jumping over the broom for a wedding, or jumping over the besom for a wedding. We can see I'm struggling already with this. And this is where couples would jump the broom to actually signify that they have a marriage that is not legally binding. It is called a handfasting. So when they jumped the broom or besom, they would enter into an agreement in front of those who were present to be with that person for a year and a day. And then after that year and the day, they would maybe get married legally. And that's where the handfasting comes from. Now you'll find jumping brooms or besoms or swords are actually very common in a lot of different cultural practices. But the one that I'm talking about has come from Britain. So now I'm just going to struggle to basically put all of these flowers on the broom. And then I'm going to wrap the ever-loving snot out of it with this ribbon. So traditionally, brooms are housed in a couple of ways. It is not a good idea to allow the bottom of the broom to actually touch the floor. So when you are storing your besom in your house, you either have it standing up or actually hanging over a doorway. Because if you have it hanging over a doorway, it's said to keep evil spirits and bad juju out of the house and good in. Now, one of my favorite movies of all time is, of course, Practical Magic. And there is that famous scene where the broom by the door falls and the aunts say, company is coming. Now, that is actually an old folk magic lore that when the broom falls in the witch's house, you will expect company soon. I'm going to be storing my new besome above the front door of my home, and I just found some large command hooks that are going to be big enough to hold it, and I'm going to place it above my doorway. So you don't need anything fancy to have them in your house. You can also paint or wood burn the actual handle as well, put charms or anything else you want to pop on there. But this was less than $20 for this entire thing, and I think that as a witch's tool, it is beautiful and pretty cost effective. If you want to learn more about modern witchcraft and the tools of the craft, check out this playlist. And remember, you do not need all of the tools of the witch to be a witch. Everything should be an addition and something that brings joy to your practice. So I'm about to fly off to my witch's Sabbat, and I'll see you all next time.